Hey everybody, this is Sister Johnny, and you know what time it is. It's time for the Holy What? Report. That's right, we're getting ready to learn some stuff today. The first article I'll be reading is by Slash Gear, and it reads, CERN's newest large hydro collider results could upend physics core theory. Physicists, prepare yourself a stiff drink. The team at CERN's large hydro collider beauty experiment have found results that could indicate a violation of the standard model of particle physics. The latest outcome of testing by the vast instrument aiming to unlock the secrets of the Big Bang and what happened in our universe right after it. The results are yet to be confirmed, but could prove to be a huge upheaval in current physics understanding. The next article is by New York Post, and it was actually posted on February 27, 2021. The real reason why Bill Gates is now the U.S.'s biggest farmland owner. Late last year, Eric O'Keefe was researching a mysterious recent purchase of 14,500 acres of prime Washington state farmland. His magazine, The Land Reporter, tracks major land transactions and produces an annual list of the 100 biggest U.S. landowners. Sales of more than 1,000 acres are blue moon event, O'Keefe noted, so this one stood out. And Eastern Washington has some of the richest, most expensive farmland in the country, but the purchaser of record was a small, obscure company in Louisiana. That immediately set off alarm bells, O'Keefe says. He assigned his research team to dig a little deeper, so they came back with the answer. The Louisiana company was acting on behalf of Cascade Investment LLC, the secretive investment firm that manages most of the huge fortune belonging to Bill Gates. Now, there's a map here that gives you an idea of just how much land Bill Gates owns. I'm going to read the caption. He's the new McDonald. Bill Gates owns hundreds of thousands of acres across the United States, including 242,000 acres of farmland, making him the country's top agricultural landholder, according to Eric O'Keefe's The Land Report. Please read this article. The next article was printed on March 26, 2021. By CNBC. Oil nations tip for political instability if the world moves away from fossil fuels. In its 2021 Political Risk Outlook on Thursday, Verisk Maplecroft said countries that had failed to diversify their economies away from fossil fuels face a slow motion wave of political instability. The most vulnerable countries are higher cost producers that are heavily dependent on oil for revenues, have lower capacity to diversify, and are less politically stable, the report says. The next article was published by Bloomberg, and this article was published on March 22, 2021. The financial services industry, braced for what could be its biggest disruption in decades, is about to get an early glimpse at the Federal Reserve's work on a new digital currency. Wall Street is not thrilled. Banks, credit card companies, and digital payments processors are nervously watching the push to create an electronic alternative to the paper bills Americans carry in their wallets, or what some call a digital dollar and others call a Fed coin. Yahoo News is reporting on March 26, 2021, the following. The new administration is prepared to issue executive orders on what rhymes with funds but begins with a G. Please read between the lines. Click on the link so you can read it word for word. The last article is published by Yahoo Finance as of March 25, 2021, and it reads, here are 17 food companies that have warned about rising inflation. Now, we know the price has gone up, but it's going to go up higher. And it reads, start saving those pennies now because your grocery bill will likely head higher soon as food giants pass along inflationary costs in transportation and those related to the new related protocols. Our commodity index points now to negative 11% and 2021 agriculture energy related cost inflation, essentially in line with what we saw in 2007, 2008, and 2011 when food sector gross margin margin contracted, said Jefferies food sector analyst Rob Dickerson in a new research note. Now, the names of these companies are in this article. I'm not going to say it. All right, that'll do it for the Holy Word Report. If you'd like to catch up on some of the previous reports, please visit me at SisterJonnie.com. That's Sister J-O-N-N-I-E.com. You can also go on over to YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like and share. Thank you so much for tuning in. Have a wonderful weekend. This is the Holy What Report, signing out.